The mudskipper is one of the few species of fish in the world capable of living out of the water. This amazing ability means it can feed on the tiny algae, crustaceans, and worms which live among the mangroves. And it comes out of the water not just to get food. Courtship also takes place on land. The male shows off his dorsal fin to the females. The problem is that the mudskippers are so small they can hardly be seen. To compensate, they will have to jump up or find a slight rise in the level of the mud. As they don't have legs, the mudskippers use their pectoral fins to propel themselves along. The fins have acquired strong muscles and even a joint halfway long, reminiscent of the elbow of land animals. To breathe, they use a system similar to the crabs. They retain water in their gills. When they ingest food, they have to expel this water, so the mudskippers constantly need to replenish their reserves. This also keeps their skin wet. This is very important because that is another way in which they absorb oxygen. Among the thousands of islands that make up the archipelago, there is one which, despite being very small, is of extraordinary value. The dangerous reefs which surround it, and its tiny size, meant that for centuries it went entirely unnoticed by the colonizers. From its appearance, you would hardly suspect the mysteries it contains. At the start of the 20th century, the island suddenly became the focus of attention. The rumor spread that its forests contained fauna which were very different from that which could be seen on its beaches. In the interior lived terrible unknown creatures. The stories became increasingly frequent, and the Indonesian government decided to send a scientific expedition. What they discovered was so amazing that in just a few years, the island went from total obscurity to worldwide fame. Within the different ecosystems, we will find different species of endemic fauna, as well as others introduced by man. Crab-eating macaques and sunda deer share the island with wild boar, pigs, goats, and buffalo. All of them, domesticated or wild, are potential prey of the great predator of the island, the animal the natives called Ora, the dragon.